Welcome to the second video on the GS1 barcode system. Here I'll delve into the internal structure and generation of GS1 compliant barcodes. Barcodes are commonly used to encode a single piece of information, such as a GTIN mentioned in the first video, within an EAN symbol. If you want to store multiple data elements in a single barcode, the data elements must be separable for further processing. For this purpose, AI data identifiers, or application identifiers, and the special character FNC1 are used. Here's an example. Let's say you want to store a GTIN, a batch number with variable length, and an expiration date in a GS1-128 code. To inform the reading application where exactly in the barcode data to find the corresponding information, mapping with AIs is done. AIs are 2-, 3-, and 4-digit numerical identifiers that determine the meaning and length of the following values. A very comprehensive list of current data identifiers is available at the displayed link. The data content associated with an AI data identifier can have a fixed or variable length. According to the specification, GTIN AI01 and expiration date AI15 are always encoded with a fixed number of characters. N2 plus N14 for GTIN, meaning 2 digits for the AI itself, and 14 digits for the GTIN. If necessary, leading zeros must be added to the GTIN to achieve the desired length. It's different with a batch number. It can contain up to 20 characters. If the full capacity of 20 characters is not used, the batch number must end with an FNC1 character. Be careful, an FNC1 is never to be used at the end of the barcode. Since this FNC1 character cannot be directly typed on the keyboard, it is specified in TEC-IT applications as an escape sequence with the character string /F. Now let's generate the code in the TEC-IT online barcode generator at barcode.tech-it.com. The data must be entered without parentheses. With GS1-128, the data identifiers are always printed in plain text surrounded by parentheses, but the parentheses are not part of the encoded payload. The good news? TEC-IT tools automatically create the correct bracketing in plain text. When scanning, only the payload without parentheses is read. Due to the AIs and their known length, or the conclusion, with FNC1, the processing system can correctly process the encoded data. That's all for today. If you find this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe.